Hello, and welcome to what's new in the June 2022 Microsoft Game Development Kit. The Microsoft GDK is a complete set of tools, APIs, extensions, and programming models that can be used across current and future Microsoft gaming platforms and initiatives. The design and features of the GDK are driven by your feedback about how you like to develop games. We're on a journey that goes back decades. With every release of the GDK, we take a step closer to a world where developing games for Xbox or PC Game Pass on Windows 10 and Windows 11 is faster and easier, no matter where you started your development. The key features and fixes that are highlighted in this video are just a handful out of dozens, a mix of improvements for both PC and Xbox development that speed up iteration times or give developers more powerful tools to optimize their game experiences. Most importantly, many of these features are the direct result of developer requests. In addition to many bug fixes, this release includes the following new features. More memory available for games. In the June GDK, additional memory is available for Xbox Series S consoles. Hundreds of additional megabytes of memory are now available to Xbox Series S developers. This gives developers more control over memory, which can improve graphics performance in memory-constrained conditions. Improved performance for graphics allocations. We've addressed an issue where graphics virtual addresses were being allocated considerably slower than non-graphics virtual addresses. This improves the speed of graphics virtual address allocation. Titles can now take better advantage of recent enhancements in memory management without negatively affecting graphics performance. Improved PC game development experiences. We've implemented numerous features that make it easier for developers to develop GDK games on PC and improve the behavior of GDK games for players. The new Xbox consoles and PC Game Pass games are built on a common toolset, the GDK. The improvements to developing and playing PC Game Pass games helps titles bridge development between the consoles. At the same time, these improvements provide optimization specifically needed for the Windows 10 and Windows 11 developer experience. For developers porting games from other marketplaces, these improvements help shorten the time and increase the number of critical features they have access to right out of the box. Platform now enforces DLC age restrictions. Developers can now have standalone DLC packages that enforce age restrictions, rather than only inheriting the age restriction settings of the parent. This change helps developers comply with and support age ratings in every market around the globe, protecting young players and avoiding customer complaints and requests for refunds. New in-game API to manage DLC storage. Developers can now provide a more seamless in-game experience to help players manage the storage of downloaded game content. Games can now directly control a locally installed content package. Players can free up space by uninstalling DLC without having to leave the in-game UI. Using this API, any package can be uninstalled by the game that it's able to launch, but it can't uninstall any DLC that isn't related to the game. Because this feature doesn't automatically provide a notification or native UI, we strongly recommend that developers provide one to players to provide a seamless experience. HDR support in Xbox Manager Remote Control View. After many requests from developers, we're pleased to announce that Xbox Manager Remote Control now supports 4K HDR video. This allows developers to remotely view and work with 4K HDR graphics directly through Xbox Manager. Support for relative versus absolute mouse positions in Xbox Manager Remote Control View. Capture Mouse Mode is new for the June GDK. In addition to capturing absolute coordinates, all mouse movements can now be sent as relative data to the title. This enhances the development capabilities for certain game types, such as first-person games. We hope that you've enjoyed learning about some of the new features in the June 2022 GDK. This video has just a few of the many investments that we make in every GDK release to help our development partners succeed. To learn more, take a look at our public GDK documentation at aka.ms/gamedevdocs. Experiment with our public version of the GDK at aka.ms/GDK. Or if you're ready, join the ID at Xbox program at xbox.com/en-us/developers/ID today.